Hello, I'm Salvatore Schifo. I'm a secretary of the Community Media Forum Europe, which is a network of policy experts that is dealing with community media policy at the European level. I am a lecturer in media policy at Marmara University, the European Union Institute in Istanbul, in Turkey. And I'm currently also doing part-time a PhD at the Communication and Media Research Institute at the University of Westminster in London, where I'm researching on the development of community radio in the UK in the decade between 1997 and 2007. So since the beginning of the Labour government in May 97, how it developed over the decade, bearing in mind different parts of social, cultural and media policy. About the future of community media, well, you know, in the UK, community radio has been introduced by a community radio holder after 30 years of lobbying by the sector in 2004, and now there are over 200 stations that have been licensed all across the UK. 150 of them are not actually broadcasting. They cover actually 10% of the population in the UK. One of the challenges that they face in the UK as well as in Europe is what we have been talking here in South Africa today about digital switchover, which basically means there's a plan called a Digital Britain that wants broadcasting to move from an analog platform to a digital platform. What this means will be a more efficient use of the spectrum. The spectrum is what we use to broadcast radio and television. This is a good solution for regional and national channels, but it's not a viable solution for community radio channels because it's very expensive first, and because it doesn't cut really for a very local audience. So what happens is if there is a move on digital broadcasting platforms, if FM wants, you know, the government wants FM to be switched off, what the sector, the Community Media Association in the UK and the Community Media Forum Europe at the European level is doing is to lobby that this platform must have what is called a must carry provision for a public service like the one community radio services do. In terms of resources you can use to know more about this, first of course is the Community Media Forum Europe website, which is www.cmfe.eu, where you find what the activities of the Community Media Forum Europe are, the documents, the consultations we respond, and the supporting activities we do to our members across Europe. And another website you can surely have a look at a project on which I'm working, which is communitymedia.eu, and is on www.communitymedia.eu, which is a website we want to connect research, teaching, policy and practice across Europe, and is including not only the European Union but the wider conception of Europe, which extends also to countries as Turkey, Russia and, you know, the European part of the Caucasus. Yes, and this is some of the structure. Surely there are some information you can get also from, you know, in terms of education by books which talk about community media and articles talk about community media. You find that link in a books session of communitymedia.eu. And if any one of you, of course, is studying also as I know radio and journalism, I suggest also a very good book has just come out this year by a colleague of ours, with Carol Fleming. It's called Radio Handbook, and tells you about radio journalism, and tells you about radio, and it's an important chapter on community radio, including a section on Siren FM. Siren FM is the university radio station in Lincoln, which gives you an example of what can be done with a community radio license in a university setting. So I wish you all good work, and hope to see you visiting one of our sites. If you want to get in touch, you have my contact details on the Community Media website. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
How was it? After this open speaking, you know.